Well, good morning, everybody. My name is Ana Belém. This is my first time here in DrupalCon, and it's a pleasure to me to be here. The title of my presentation is SmarTest, Accelerating the Detection of Faults in Drupal. SmarTest is a new testing module to improve the process of testing in Drupal. Before starting with the presentation of this work, let me introduce myself and my team. I'm Ana Belén Sánchez, and I'm a computer engineer. I work as a teacher and as a researcher at the University of Seville here in Spain. In particular, I'm a member of the research group of applied software engineering. I work with Sergio Segura and Antonio Ruiz Cortés. Both of them are my PhD advisors. Gabriel Hidalgo does work as technical support. Well, this is the path I will follow during the presentation, during the talk. First, I will explain the introduction and the motivation to make this work. Then I will describe our approach and the evaluation. Then I will show you SmarTest and a demo of SmarTest. And finally, I will summarize the conclusions. Introduction. Well, why am I here in DrupalCon? I'm a PhD student, and my topic of thesis is the automated testing on variability-intensive systems. What is that of variability-intensive systems? Variability software refers to the ability of a software system to be extended, customized, to be configured, to be changed, to be used in a particular context. So, software exposing a high degree of variability are referred as variability software systems. So, for example, operating systems like Linux, applications like Eclipse, or cloud applications like Amazon have been reported as variability-intensive systems. So any software that has a high number of plugins or components that can be configured leading to different final configurations can be considered variability-intensive systems. Okay, in order to model the variability of this kind of system, this kind of variability-intensive systems, in my research context are really popular the feature models. Feature model helps to model the variability and to know to represent all the components in a system and the relationships among the components. So a feature model represents all the possible configurations of the variability in terms of systems in terms of features and relationships among them. For example, this is a feature model, a small feature model representing a mobile phone system. It's just an example. All the components in a mobile phone, in this example, are represented by features that are represented by rectangles. All these ones are rectangles. So this is the call support for the mobile phone, GPS support, the screen, media, and so on. The relationships among the features are represented among edges, and the hierarchical relationships among the features, among the components in a mobile phone, in these examples, are divided into mandatory relations that are represented by a black circle. So mandatory features, like calls, are features that always have to be presented, have to be included in all the configurations of a mobile phone. So call support have to be included in all the configuration of a final mobile phone, that means. Another kind of hierarchical relationships are the optional relations. So for example, the GPS is an optional feature for mobile phones. That means that can be optionally included in the final configuration of a mobile phone. There are another kind of relationships, of hierarchical relationships, like alternative or. Okay. In addition to the hierarchical relationships, feature models can also contain constraints that are constraints that are usually presented in the form of requires, constraints, and excludes. So, for example, in this feature model, if our mobile phone presents a camera, has a camera, the high resolution, the screen, our screen has to be a high resolution because we have a requires between a camera and a high resolution feature. Another kind of constraint are the exclude constraints. So GPS, if GPS is presented in our final configuration, in our mobile, our screens can't be a basic screen. Must be a color or a high resolution screen because we have a exclude constraint. This is an example of a final configuration of a mobile phone system. Our mobile phone has call support, screen with high resolutions, media with camera. So this is a feature model. In my research context, are really important because helps to model the variability of variability intensive systems. And also they are really important because they can be automatically analyzed in order to extract important information from them. Motivation. Testing variability intensive systems is extremely challenging due to the potentially huge number of derivable configurations under test. So, for example, Debian Wisi is a well-known Linux distribution, has been reported as a variability intensive system, has more than 37,000 of packages. So, these packages can be configured in order to lead into billions of configurations. So test each configuration is infeasible in many cases and time-consuming. To alleviate this problem, many contributions have been proposed. So, for example, test case selection techniques is one of the most used and one of the most important techniques in this area. This test case selection technique reduces the test space by selecting a portion of the configurations to be tested. However, the number of configurations resulting from this kind of test techniques could be still high and expensive to run. If you think, imagine when you are, this is especially costly during regression testing. When you have to repeatedly execute the test when any relevant change is made to the code. Another kind of testing technique for variability intensive system is test case prioritization technique that schedule test cases for execution in an order that attempts to increase their effectiveness and meeting some performance goal. Many goals can be defined. So, for example, a tester may wish to order their test cases in order to increase the rate of fault detection, for example. Given a goal, you can define different prioritization criteria, different ordering criteria. So, for example, if we want to increase the rate of fault detection, we can order our test cases in order to based on previous execution, based on the fault detected in previous execution, or based on the components that are propensity to faults. Another important problem testing variability intensive systems is how to evaluate these testing techniques. Last year, the number of contributions to alleviate the process of testing is growing rapidly, but it's hard to find real software system, real variability intensive systems with available code, with good description, with good documentation, with fault reports, and so on, in order to evaluate the testing techniques. As results, many authors in the academy context and industry context use artificial software and artificial feature, faults, random information in order to simulate the evaluation of these testing techniques. Our approach. I'm trying to show you our approach to resolve the above problems. Okay. The first step that we followed was look into the open source community in order to find real variability intensive systems to evaluate this kind of testing techniques. So we study and analyze tools like Drupal, Joomla, WordPress, Eclipse, PrestaShop, ERPs like OpenBravo and Magento. We look for tools with available code, with backtrack access to the backtracking system, with bugs related with the module that caused this bug. We also look for tools with good documentations. Was really hard to find this kind of characteristics in these tools. So it's interesting that among all the tools considered in our study, only one of them meets all the expectations. Do you guess which one? Yes, Drupal. Excuse me. Drupal has available code. Drupal has detailed full reports, severity description, full descriptions, description about the severity of the faults, status of faults, access to the backtracking system. Also, most of modules in Drupal has automated test cases. Drupal have an extensive documentation. All this information, together with the high number of members in the community of Drupal, more than 630,000 users and developers, made that we chose Drupal as our case study. Also, Drupal has more than 30,000 modules that make into a variability intensive system. Okay, with all this information, we perform a study to evaluate our proposal for testing techniques. So the study is this one, variability testing in the wild, the Drupal case study. This work was published as an article in the journal Software and System Modeling that ranks ninth in the ranking of engineering software journals in the world. So if you are interested in reading this article, this is the reference. Okay, so now I will try to summarize this work that inspired us to develop the SmarTest module. The first step was analyze the info files of each module in Drupal in order to know the dependencies of each of the module with the rest of the modules in Drupal. Also, we analyze, we study the Drupal documentation, and we use the module JITs in order to have a graphical representation of all the modules in Drupal and the relationships among them. Well, this is our first contribution in our study. We model a complete Drupal feature model, but we only consider 48 modules in our study. This is the complete feature models, okay? And this is just an example. In order to show you an example of a part of our feature model. Okay, according to the Drupal documentation, when you install and enable a new module in Drupal, in the Drupal system, you are adding a new feature. So based on that, we model each module in Drupal as a feature in our Drupal feature model. Okay, so the first step was we selected all the core modules that in Drupal that have to be always enabled, in the system. So you know, nodes, comments, field, users. Then we chose among the most installed modules in Drupal, among the core modules, optional core modules in Drupal, additional modules. So for example, we selected core modules in Drupal that can be optionally included or enabled in Drupal, like path, and we included additional modules like views or Google Analytics. Okay, so all the core modules in Drupal that all we have to be enabled in Drupal has been modeled like mandatory features, mandatory relations in a feature model. And all the optional modules have been modeled like optional features that can be optionally included in the configurations. Okay. Dependencies. We analyze all the info files and dependencies of each module in Drupal, and we found 21 non-redundant dependencies. I said non-redundant because we found redundant dependencies in Drupal, like, for example, forum has a dependencies with field module, but field module is a module that always have to be enabled in Drupal, so this was considered as a redundant dependency. So we eliminate all the redundant dependencies and we obtain, as a result, 21 no redundant dependencies. So our Drupal feature model in our study has 48 modules, 21 dependencies, and more than 2,000 millions of configurations. That's just with a part of Drupal, we have a variability intensive system. Okay. Once we have the Drupal feature model, we extract information from Drupal in order to try to guide the testing in Drupal. So the first information that we extracted from each module in Drupal was the module size in terms of lines of code without counting blank lines and comments. This information can help us to know the complexity of a module and maybe the propensity to faults of this module. It's just an hypothesis. Then we collected all the number, all the chains in a module. This is based, this fact is based in several reported that said, in academic and industry reported that said that when you made a change in a code, is likely to introduce faults. So based on that, we collected the number of commits from the Git repository of Drupal in a period of 2 years, from May 2012 to April 2014. Okay, we also obtained information about the number of tests included in all the modules in Drupal in our study, all the modules considered in our study, and we obtained 352 test cases and 24,152 assertions. We also analyzed the cyclomatic complexity of each module in Drupal, and we used the PHP log tool in order to calculate the cyclomatic complexity. This information is really important because we know that cyclomatic complexity is related with the propensity to faults of modules. Also, we extracted information about the Drupal installation of each module, the number of installation of each module. We collected this information in order to know the popularity, the relevance of each module in Drupal. And also, we collected information about the number of contributors that are working on each module. And the last information that we extracted from Drupal for the backtracking system was, and the most important one, was the number of faults. We collected faults in two consecutive versions of Drupal, 7.22 and 7.23 version of Drupal. And we also collected the faults during a period of 2 years, from May 2012 to April 2014. Okay. We first collected all the faults found in each module in Drupal. Then we eliminate those faults that were not accepted by the Drupal community, like duplicated faults, like non-reproducible faults, and faults that working as designed. Then we analyze all the faults in order to find the faults that were caused by the integration, by the interaction of two modules. Of different modules. We obtain 160 integration faults in total. And from then, we found 132 faults caused by the interaction of two modules, 25 of them caused by the interaction of three modules, and three of them were triggered by the interaction of three modules. Interestingly, the modules with the higher number of integration faults were C-tools and views. Okay. With all this information, we performed a correlation study in order to know the relation between all this information extracted from Drupal and the propensity to faults of the module related with this information. So the first correlation that we performed was this one. We studied the relation between a module size and the number of faults in a module. And the result of this correlation was a strong positive correlation. So those modules with the higher the size of the module, the higher the number of faults found on it. So this is a really interesting information that we found in our study. Correlation number two, we study the relation between the changes found in a module and the propensity to faults of that module. And the result of this study was a strong positive correlation. So the higher the number of changes found in a module, the higher the faults found on it. So that's really interesting too, in order to guide the testing. The third correlations. We study the relation between the number of faults found in a module in a version of Drupal and the number of faults found in that module in the following version of Drupal. And was really interesting because the result was a strong positive correlation. That means that if you have a module with a higher number of faults in a version of Drupal, this module is likely to have a higher number of faults in the following version of Drupal. Correlation number four. We study the correlation of the cyclomatic complexity of a module and the propensity to faults of this module. We obtain a positive correlation. That means the higher the cyclomatic complexity of a module, the higher the propensity to faults of that module. Correlation number five. This is interesting because we perform a correlation between the relation in between a module with a higher number of contributors and the propensity to faults of that module. And we hypothesize that those modules with a higher number of contributors will have more faults in order to, based on the fact that coordination problems because of the higher number of contributors. But the correlation was negative. That means that not only reject our hypothesis, but confirm the opposite. So those modules with higher number of contributors has less faults. So that's really interesting. Correlation number six. We also study the number of test cases in a module and the number of faults found on it. We hypothesize that those modules with a higher number of test cases will have less faults, basing off that they are exactly tested. But the correlation was poor, so we cannot conclude anything in that case. Another important information is that we found that the 91% of optional modules has faults in our case study, and only the 41% of core mandatory modules has faults. That's mean too. Okay, so basis in our correlation study, we try to define a prioritization criteria in order to prioritize, in order to order our test cases looking for the propensity to faults of our module in order to detect faults as soon as possible. So we define four different prioritization criteria based on the correlation that correlated well with the propensity to faults. So we define the size driving criteria, fault driving criteria, change driving criteria, and cyclomatic criterion. For example, size driving criterion order our test case based on the size of each module. So those test cases related with the modules exposing a higher number of lines of code will be executed first. Based on our correlation study, we will get accelerating the detection of faults. So the same happened with the rest of the prioritization criterion that we define. Then we evaluate this proposal. We try to give an answer for this question. Could we accelerate the detection of faults in Drupal using previous information? Well, we use the Drupal case study and we apply test case selection. And we get an acceleration detecting faults of 86.2%. That's a really good result. This result was calculated with a metric. It's a standard metric for measure the acceleration of faults called APFD. And then we apply fault driving criterion to the selection, to the result of the test case selection. And we obtain an acceleration detecting fault of 94.2%. So this is a really good result, too. So based on these good results, we ask us why not apply our proposal, our study, to a real tool, to the Drupal, to Drupal system. And first, we try to analyze how Drupal tests its modules and its tests, and we try to analyze SimpleTest, is the core module for testing in Drupal, in order to know how work SimpleTest and in order to know how we can help with the process of testing. Okay. I will show you the process that I followed in order to improve a SimpleTest. First, I will show you SimpleTest. SimpleTest has show you a list of tests and group of tests in order to you can select the test that you want to run, and then you click run and the tests are executed. This is SimpleTest. So this is the main view of SimpleTest. So we try to improve the tester experience in Drupal, and we develop SmarTest in order to improve SimpleTest. So this is SmarTest. It's just a first approach. This is the main view of SmarTest. No, not now. Okay. And SmarTest, the main view of SmarTest is a customizable dashboard with information, with real information in real time. So this is information about my system. So the first widget that you can see in my dashboard, you can configure your own dashboard, is system information based on previous execution. So you have information about the code coverage of your system, of all the modules installed in your system, in your Drupal system. You also have information about the tests that failed in the last executions and the number of exceptions found in the last execution of your test and the number of tests that pass. And also you have information about the modules with less coverage presenting in descending order. And information about the modules with more faults. And also we have information about the time that took the last test execution. Also the second widget that I have in my dashboard is a cloud of tags. So you can see words and the size of the words of the tags represent the lines of code, and the color represent the cyclomatic complexity. So you can see that views, simple tests, C-tool, systems has a higher number of lines of code and cyclomatic complexity. So we recommend you that you start to testing this kind of module because our propensity to false, at least in my system. Okay. The third widgets, we show you a top five of modules in descending order of lines of code. Also, we can show you a top five modules in descending order of cyclomatic complexity. And this widget is really important too because show you the number of tests that fail and the number of exceptions found in the last test executions in descending order too. So in my case, image has 24 tests that fail in the last executions and 40 exceptions. So we need to focus in this module in order to resolve my problems. Okay, and the last one we presented with a last test executions graphic with a top five modules in order to the modules that pass most tests. Okay, so this is a customizable dashboard. You can add new widgets. This is my dashboard that I configured, but you can add more widgets. So this is the view in order to add widgets. So I will try to create a new widget. So for example, you can select top five modules or top 10 modules or select the module that you want. This is all the modules I have enabled in my system. So I will select top 10 modules. For example, coverage. You can select the graphic types, line, column, and you can select the widget type, graphic or cloud, and the name, code, coverage, DrupalCon. Okay. And then generate. And this is my new widget. You can see a widget with 10 top modules in descending order based on the code coverage. So this is totally customizable. You can remove the widget that you want. And also you can save your dashboard. You can create a new dashboard and save all the configurations that you want in your dashboard and then load the configuration that you want. This is a totally customizable dashboard. Okay, let's move on to test case prioritization. This is a similar view of SimpleTest, but it's different because we include prioritization criterion. We include criterion based on lines of code, cyclomatic complexity of each module, failed tests, tests with exceptions, code coverage, and git changes of each module. So you can select the prioritization criterion of your test case, of your test suite that you want. So for example, I will select cyclomatic complexity. And please look at here, because the order will change. So click Save Configurations, and the order of the test is changed because we order our test cases in order to the cyclomatic complexity, in order to find those tests that has more propensity to faults. So if I change the prioritization criterion, we can get another different order. Okay, so we show you information about the cyclomatic complexity of each module, of each test, and also we show you information about the time that took the last execution. I think that this is important in order to know how many time, how much time take the test. So we also show you a stop button in order to include the time that you want for running your test, okay, in hours or minutes. So I will show you an example of the executions of the test because we improve simple tests. With simple tests, you have to wait until all the tests are finished in order to get results. we improve this this view in order to get result when the first test had been finished. This helps to the tester to start to debugging and to get feedback continuous. So you have result. The first test has been finished. And this is all the information. You can see information about test class name, status, message, and you can also follow the trace. Okay? So this helps us to start debugging and to reduce effort too. So the tests are being had been executing in the order that I selected, in basis on the cyclomatic complexity, because we can obtain faults earlier basis on this proportion. Okay, so if you click stop process, finish the execution, and you can save all the information here. You have all the information about the test that has been executed until now. Okay. Also, we propose to use several configuration of our test, of our smart test module. We include a view in order to fill out the form to extract Git changes from the Git repository of Drupal. So also you can configure the cron in order to automatically mining the repository with the Git commits. Okay. So this is just an example of smart test. No, no, it's not the end. This is just some screenshots. Okay. And finally, the conclusions. What improvement do we add to simple tests? Okay, customizable dashboard with runtime extracted data to Git the testing. Test prioritization to detect faults faster. Automated testing with feedback in real time. And tying up option to automatically stop the test execution. Things that we are working on. Add new widget to the dashboard. Include multi-prioritization criteria based on genetic algorithms to detect faults faster. We are working to develop this kind of algorithms. Study the integration of SmarTest with other test systems like PHATs, PHP units. Get Smart is accepted in Drupal. Now it's in Sandbox. Any suggestion? Okay. Thank you very much.